Every year, billions upon trillions of innocent plants are killed for the purpose of human consumption.
In the arms of the angel, fly away from here, from this dark, cold hotel room, and the endlessness that you fear. You are pulled from the wreckage of your soul.
This is a documentary.
Meatatarians. Who are they, and what do they want? My name is Not Felicia, and we will be finding out on this documentary episode. We're here now with Dr. Beat, a real doctor and professional vegetable researcher.
That's right.
So, Doctor, tell us a little bit about your views on plant consumption.
Well, it turns out humans don't actually need plants in their diets. We can get the same vitamins and minerals from other natural sources. For example, children who are lactose intolerant have taken a liking to chalk water as a source of calcium.
So what are some scientific reasons that one might not want to eat vegetables?
Well, eating vegetables every day may actually be detrimental to your health. For example, blueberries. If you eat too many, your pee will turn blue.
This is Martha, a self-proclaimed meatatarian and veggies rights activist.
That's right.
All right, Martha, tell us a little bit about your views on plant consumption.
Ooh, those vegans and those vegetarians are gonna burn in hell for their sins. A plant's life is just as valuable and precious and irreplaceable as a human's.
Well, what about animals?
You really think an animal, a creature walking around in its own filth and swill, is worthy, as precious, as pure, as something as beautiful as a piece of broccoli?
So what about the taste? I mean, don't you get tired of eating only meat all the time? Don't you crave a nice salad every once in a while?
Did you just say salad?
Yes.
That is one of the most offensive things I've ever thought I'd hear. Salad is one of the most inhumane words, corpses upon corpses. It's just a description of a landmass, a mass grave of innocence. That word should be censored from here on out. I don't want to hear that word again.
So you like eating?
That's right. I eat every day.
And what is it about that you like?
Well, it's easy to make and cheap and healthy.
But doctors are saying that it's not really that good for you.
Well, doctors are always changing their opinions on things. Nothing's really healthy anymore, so I think I'll just stick to eating.
So, doctor, you have some of your research here with you today.
Yes. We have our 5-year research project proving that plants actually have the capability to feel pain and emotion. Our study has included taking microsonic electrowaves from the nerve cells of plants and converting them into sound we can hear.
And you have a sample here with us today?
Correct. Here we have our first sound recording of a plant's pain in a form humans can hear. No one has heard this yet, So this will be the first time we are playing it. It is the sound of a plant being uprooted.
Love that green. I totally support that stuff.
Doctors are saying that it's bad for you now. And it's got emotions. I would norm the stuff. Except for poison ivy. That can burn. You got a cigarette?
When I feel bad, my mom knows what to do. She says I'll make specially for you. Put in tomatoes, ham, and lettuce too. It's that I made for you.
I like eating. I like eating. I like eating. Thank you for the.
Sometimes when I feel sad, my mom knows what to do. She says I'll make especially for you. Put in bananas and some cherries too. Here's the that I made for you.
I like eating. I like eating. I like eating. Thank you for the
when I have a birthday party once a year, then I'm so happy that my friends will all be here. Mum will make us have ice cream too. It's a party for me and you.